Welcome back, YouTubers and Madden fans. This is Madden Money Shot, sniffing at the Madden cheese as always. Got another Madden 22 preview video. Today I'm going to be going over my top 5 worst teams to pick, whether it's franchise modes or CFM. These are going to be the top 5 worst teams to use in Madden 22 when the game comes out. Teams that should be avoided at all costs. Now, me personally, I don't typically think that there is too many bad teams when it comes to Madden, but this year seems different. There seems to be a lot of stinkers out there. If you guys want to see more videos like this, do me a favor, hit the like button, let me know in the comment section. I want to do more videos like top 10 offenses, top 10 defenses for Madden 22 going into next year's game. So hit the like button if you want to see that. Now, I'm using updated rosters, which, you know, has all the draft classes and stuff like that. So I will show you guys before I get into this video, because I had a lot of people asking last time how I got updated rosters on Madden 21. So I'll go ahead and I'll show that real quick before I get into the top 5 teams. All you want to do is go down to the settings. Then you want to go to share and manage files, download community files. Then you just go over to the roster tab, and I'm going to be using TFG Real 2021. This is from a YouTuber by the name of The Franchise Guy. The guy actually sent me an email not too long ago. I never actually responded, but I do know of this guy. So he has probably the best roster on here for sure. So download that community file, and then you'll have the exact same roster that I do. You can do offline stuff, franchise modes and stuff like that. So starting off at number 5, there's no real particular order that I have these in. So number 5, this team could easily be considered number 1, but Deshaun Watson might not be on this team by the time the year starts. It's really hard to say, but for now, you do have a top flight quarterback, and they do have a pretty good stable of running backs with Philip Lindsay, David Johnson, Mark Ingram. So there is some talent. They also have some pretty decent receivers too. Brandon Cooks is still here, has a lot of speed. Kenny Stills. So ultimately, this is a roster I think you can make a lot of hay with, but there's just no real over-the-top talent when it comes to skill position players. They don't even really have a tight end. The offensive line is okay, but that's one of the biggest issues, is they got rid of all their top-tier talent. They don't have J.J. Watt anymore. They don't really have anybody along the defensive line. They're, you know, pretty much just a lot of average or below-average players, which is not really going to get it done when you're going against teams that actually have superstar players. And if they lose to Deshaun Watson, this team is completely barren of young talent based off of the fact that they haven't had a first-round pick in, like, the last 3 years. So that's just going to make this, you know, not a fun team to build and not a fun team to use online. Another team that could kind of be in that boat is the Falcons. If they get rid of Julio Jones before the game drops, which it sounds like they're going to do, if he's traded, this all of a sudden becomes a pretty average team, or maybe even worse. You got a really old non-mobile quarterback in Matt Ryan, although he is still a pretty good player. I like Mike Davis in real life. I don't like him in this game. He's way too slow. So the running backs are definitely hurting. And then after that, I mean, Calvin Ridley's still a really good player. You did draft a really good tight end, Kyle Pitts, so they still have a few weapons. But the offensive line isn't that great. The defensive line isn't really that great. I mean, you know, they just don't really have a ton of playmakers. Grady Jarrett's a really good player, though. Linebacker-wise, nothing really special. They do have Deion Jones, and they have some speed at linebacker. And a couple of young cornerbacks that you really have to work up, but they're all below 75. AJ Terrell didn't even have a good year, so he might be even lower. So ultimately, this secondary is complete trash, which is probably one of the most important things when it comes to Madden. Next up, I got the Lions. I mean, let's be honest, this list should be called the annual Lions Invitational, because they're always on this list every year that I do it, based off the fact that the Lions just can't get out of their own way. They've been a bad franchise for a long time, but at least they always had Matt Stafford, which was a very good quarterback in this game. Now they don't even have that. Now they got Jared Goff, who's probably one of the worst quarterbacks in the game. Their running back situation is okay. I mean, between, you know, they got a couple of good running backs, DeAndre Swift, nothing special though. Once again, receiving wise, they're pretty barren. I think you can make a pretty good receiving core though out of Terrell Williams and Brett Perryman because of their speed. Marvin Hall, Khalif Raymond, they got some speed guys, which ultimately is the most important thing, but it's not like they really have the quarterback to take advantage of it. TJ Hockenson is a decent tight end, but he's not super fast. The offensive line is actually pretty solid. They have 3 guys that should be over 80 if you include Penei Sewell, but like I said, weapons, they really don't have any weapons. So the defense is probably their stronger suit when it comes to some of their defensive linemen. They got a couple guys over 80, nothing really special though, which is kind of the problem. Their secondary, once again, pretty average. I like Dunbar and Okuda. If you take this in franchise mode, might be easy to work up, But ultimately, this team just doesn't have a ton going for it. Not a lot of juice. Next up, we got the Jets. Now, this is a team that I might actually say is a pretty good team to build in a franchise mode. I mean, you got a young quarterback. It's got a lot of talent, mobile with a big arm. Running backs, I mean, they did draft a running back in Michael Carter. And Tevin Coleman's kind of just a guy at this point. So they really don't have a ton there. Receiver, once again, not a lot of ton of weapons. If you don't have a lot of weapons, that's a really easy way to make this list. But they did draft a couple of young guys. They did bring in Corey Davis. They did draft Denzel Mims last year in the second round. They drafted Elijah Moore this year. I think he'll be a little bit faster than that. So they have some young guys to work up and a pretty decent young receiving core. No real tight end to speak of. The offensive line is average to below average, although once again, they did draft some guys like Elijah Vera Tucker, which you can probably work up, but you can't work up everybody. On the defensive side, it's pretty pathetic on that side as well. They do have a couple of decent guys like CJ Mosley, who's an older guy, not necessarily sure you can be able to hang on to him too long. The cornerback situation is abysmal. There's really nothing here at all, which is always a problem. I mean, you need a secondary so you're not getting burnt. Luckily, they have a couple of decent safeties, but ultimately, this is a team that's very far away from being a competent competitive football team. So if you take them in a franchise mode, which is probably the only hope they have, get ready to, you know, go to work, because they're going to need a lot of it to turn this team around. And then last but not least, I got the team that had the number one pick in this last year's draft. This is a pretty good team to take in franchise mode, so I wasn't really 100% about putting them on this list, especially if you have a guy like Trevor Lawrence. But ultimately, if you choose this team in regs, they got a long way to go before being a competitive team. Trevor Lawrence, though, is a real good player to have. Obviously, he's not going to be too great his first year. They have some decent running backs in Travis Etienne and James Robinson, who was a Pro Bowler last year. They also have Carlos Hyde, so they can definitely run the ball. A couple of decent receivers as well with DJ Chark, Marvin Jones, Laviska Shenault is a guy that you can definitely boost up over time in a franchise mode. They don't really have a tight end. Their offensive line is pretty average or below average. On the defensive side, they have a couple of young good guys like Josh Allen. They do have Miles Jack, which is probably one of the better linebackers in the game. Secondary wise, once again, still pretty average to below average. The fifth team was definitely the hardest one to pick out. I don't really feel great about putting the Jaguars on here, but I need a fifth team. So I think based on the fact they were the worst team in the league last year, it's not too much of a stretch. So I'm going to go ahead and end the video there. If you guys want to see more videos like this, I want to do a top offensive video, top teams that were the best offenses, top teams with the best defenses going into Madden 22. So if you want to see those videos, hit the like button and let me know in the comment section. Other than that, thanks for watching, man. Wish it out.
Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my bids and more. Link in the description below.